Grandpapa. The black machine. They gotta go in 18 stories down below the ground. Each night, Papa, they tip the world on its head, and everything loose goes rattling to the bottom. Then they hook them by the heels, hang them up, and cut them open. Only by this time, they ain't got no guts, no innards. Some beatable gears and stuff. Bleeding. Nothing but rust.
Well, well! Here's the chip. Old Death and Dumb. Got your broom in your hand. Didn't y'all know you're supposed to stay in your room till that bell ring a ding ding? Look at you. You're so big you can eat an apple off of my head. Yet you're scared as a baby. Get sweeping, boy! Get sweeping, loony! Oh, geez, Robin, you son of a bitch.
If you don't mind, Mr. Warren.
Sorry, Miss Ratchet.
Mean old Monday morning, you know. Such a lot to get done.
Yes, Miss Ratchet.
Mr. Warren, if you would start by getting poor Mr. Brompton seated, then dormitory duty, please.
Good morning, Miss Ratchet.
That's fine. Good morning.
I'm sorry, I meant to move my mats, you see.
Never mind. We better get started. Hadn't we?
Medication time. Medication, gentlemen.
Get your hands off me, God!
walk away from me, boy! We got rules here!
And right now, I've got to take your temperature and get your
shower. All you got to do is let me get acquainted with my new buddies here, understand?
Thank you, Mr. Warren. That will be all.
Howdy, ladies. Let me just tell you this, all right? I'll cooperate with you 100%. 100%. Look, I'll be right down the line. You watch. I think we ought to get to the bottom of old R.P. McMurphy.
Admission. Now they gotta fix up the controls. Do things tend to make a change. They always mess up too much. They always break up in the end. I remember this one night they bring in this big fat man with a long white beard. Then they pin him down and tranquilize him, and by the morning he's all skinny and clean shaven. The black machine. They got me way back ago. The way they got you.
Martini! Huh? Are you with us? Sure. Mr. Cheswick!
Me? No.
You mean there's not a man in here who has an opinion on this matter?
Juxtaposition of one person to another, you know, the form and the content.
Hardy, why don't you knock off the bullshit and get to the point?
Is this the point? This is the point, Scanlon. It's not bullshit. I'm not just talking about my wife. I'm talking about my life. I'm not just talking about one person. I'm talking about everybody. I'm talking about form, and I'm talking about content, and in the relationships, and God, and the devil, and heaven, and hell. Do you understand, finally?
No, Hardy, you're so fucking dumb, I can't believe it.
You feel very peculiar. Very peculiar. Like that.
Peculiar? What does that mean?
Peculiar.
Peculiar!
That is marinette. That is.
Matt! Matt! You don't want to listen to anything! You don't want to learn anything! He's got his talent!
Cheswick, do me a favor.
But they're all ganging up on you, Mr. Hardy. They're all ganging up on you.
I think that's news. Please stay off my side.
But I just want it.
Please.
I only wanted to. I just want
Please,
to...
Nurse Ratchet, you see, the other day you made some allusions
no!
to some sexual problems.
Illusions, huh? What does that mean?
Illusions. Not illusions, Scanlon. A fucking illusions. A illusions!
No, I'm gonna think of some kind of
moment. All right.
You sit down immediately, Mr. McMurphy!
Please, continue.
Before you arrived, we were discussing Mr. Harding's
God. Pleasure to meet you.
McMurphy, McMurphy. One more. Let me see. Here we are. McMurphy, Randall Patrick, committed by the state for a diagnosis and possible treatment. Randall, could you tell me a little bit about why you've been sent over?
Well, I don't know, Doc. What's it say down there?
Well, there's a number of things. There should be the belligerent. Talked when unauthorized, resentful in attitude towards work in general, that you're lazy.
Chewing gum in class, Doc.
The real reason you've been sent over here, Randall, is to be evaluated. They wish to determine whether you're truly mentally ill or not. Why do you think they might?
As near as I can figure out, Doc, it's because I fight and fuck too much.
That is certainly part of the reason. Yes, it says here that you have 5 arrests for assault. Can you tell me anything about that?
5 fights, huh? Rocky Marciano's got 40 and he's a millionaire, Doc.
That's true.
That is
true. Of course, it also is true that you went in for a rape, is it not?
It was statutory, Doc. You know what I mean? She was 15 going on 35, right? And she had told me, you know, she told me she was 18, Doc, and she was very willing, you know what I mean? Practically had to take to sewing my pants shut, you know, no man alive could resist that, and that's why I got into jail to begin with. And now they're trying to tell me what, fucking crazy over here? Because then I'll sit there like a goddamn vegetable. You know, it don't make a bit of sense to me, Doc. That's what being crazy is, then I'm senseless. Out of it. I've gotten down the fucking road wacko, but no more, no less.
Well, it says here, Randall, they think that you've been faking it in order to get out of your work detail. It says, do not overestimate the possibility this man might be feigning psychosis in order to escape the drudgery of the work. Let's be frank for a minute, Randall. Do you think there is anything wrong with your mind?
Not a thing, Doc. I'm a goddamn marvel of modern science.
You're still gonna be here for peers so we can evaluate, right? You see, we operate here on the principle of therapeutic community, meaning this very ward is society in miniature. And since society decides who is sane and who is not, we must measure up. Our goal is a completely democratic ward run by the patients, working to restore you to the outside. The most important thing is to let nothing fester inside of you, Randall. You must talk, discuss, confess, group therapy. Help yourself and your new friends probe the secrets of the subconscious. Bring old guilt down to the open. Well, if you're happy, Nurse Ratchet.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you, gentlemen. Meeting adjourned.
Billy.
Miss Ratchet says it should talk about...
You're telling me that this crap that went on today is doing some kind of good?
It's therapeutic.
Hey, listen, buddy, there ain't nothing therapeutic about that shit. You're like a bunch of fucking chickens at a pecking party.
A pecking party. Your quaint hometown speech, you know, it's quite wasted here, my friend. Think about who you're talking to. There's no offense, Billy. He has literally no inclination as to what you're talking about.
Well, I'll just explain it to him, won't I?
A flock gets a side or a speck of blood on some chicken, right? And then they all go pecking at it, see? So there's bloods and bones and feathers all over the place. But usually, a couple of the flock get blood stuck a little finger. And then it's their turn. And then the next. See where I'm going with this, don't you, son?
Yeah, no.
That certainly is a pleasant analogy, and I guess I'm the chicken with a spot of blood.
That's right, buddy, and you want to know something else? That mean old nurse, she's the one that takes the first bite.
Well, it's as simple as that.
That's right.
You've been on our ward for what, one night? And you've already simplified the work of Sigmund Freud and Maxwell Jones down to one simple analogy. It's a pecking party. It's as if you completely disregard the fact that any questions made by Nurse Ratchet or any comments made by Billy and his friends are for therapeutic reasons. I had judged you were more intelligent, but you're nothing more than a backwards braggart with no more sensitivity than a goose.
Yeah?
But kind of intelligent, nevertheless.
You know what,
wait,
buddy?
Wait, Mac. Are you saying that Nurse Ratchet's chicken?
A monster!
Oh, he's a psychopath, Billy, with definite sadistic tendencies, probably motivated by some sort of unreasoned egomania. I'm sure you're quite skilled as a competent therapist, and Jeff, eh? I'm sure that renders you quite capable of criticizing Nurse Ratchet's behavior. Procedure. I'm sure with your natural talents, my friend, you could work subconscious miracles, can't you? Soothe the aching id and kill the aching superego. Nurse Ratchet is strict, but she's not some sort of giant monster of the poetry clan bent on sadistically pecking out your eyes. Trust me, Billy.
She ain't pecking at your fucking eyes. She's going right for your balls! Your ever-loving balls! She's a ball guard, and right, she gets you where it hurts the most. Hey, you ever been needing the nuts in a brawl? Nope, didn't think so. Sad. And that's what that old lady keeps doing. She lets the guys go on about your wife. Why, Harden? Because she knows that's where it's gonna hurt you the worst. She's a ball cutter and a bitch. And you know it, Harden.
Our Nurse Ratchet is a veritable angel of mercy. You know, she's unselfish as the wind. She tolls away thanklessly for the good of all, day after day, 5 long days a week, and that takes heart, my friend. That takes heart. She's a bitch. Oh my god, she's a bitch. Billy, my boy, he's right.
Game, boys. Blackjack.
each smoke's worth one die. But there's a rule, man. We're not supposed to gamble. Miss Ratchet.
Well, what she don't know can't hurt her. Right, bets in, boys.
Hey, Matt. What's this?
That's a dime, Martini.
I better make one.
Dime's the limit, Martini.
I bet a dime.
This is not a dime. This is a dime. If you break it in half, you don't get 2 nickels. You get shit. You try and smoke it, you understand?
I don't get it.
Really? All right, let's get this thing started. Parting with abuse, queen to the chess, big ball to Scanlon, and the Billy to match his wang. Martini gets a picture and the dealer deals with
him.
It's not your turn, Martini.
But I bet
it's not. You can't bet. You can't bet, goddammit, Martini, because it's not your turn yet, right? You see these other people? These are the real fucking ones. These are the real people playing the game. Understand? Now what do? Harden, you hit or you stick? Right. That's 17 up. Stays Cheswick. All right, Scanlon.
Shut up! Ooh. Fuck! Trust!
I guess that's you busted. Billy? He sticks with a 10.
Hit me!
I can't because you didn't make a bet!
I couldn't die!
It's not a dime, Martini, all right? Just take one. There, you got one. 20 showing.
No. No, it's not. It's 10, 11, 12.
No, that's the fucking queen here, right? That's the queen. So you don't count the this and the this.
Hit
you me. Got 20 showing!
It's over,
Jimmy! Christ, I can't hear myself think in this place. Hold on a second, will ya?
Ha ha ha.
excuse me, miss. You don't think it might be possible if we just ease the music down a little so a couple of the guys could talk?
That music's for everybody, Mr. McCarthy.
Yes, well, I know that, ma'am. But you don't think it might be possible if we just ease it down just a little so we didn't have to always shout?
What you probably don't realize is that there are a lot of old men on this board who couldn't hear the music if we turned it any lower. That music is all they have. Now, if you don't know, I've got plenty to be getting on with.
Well, I am sorry, ma'am.
Medication time. Medication, gentlemen.
What's in the horse pill?
It's just medicine. It's good for you.
Yeah, well, I don't like the idea of taking something if I don't know what it is.
There's no need to get upset.
I'm not getting upset, Nurse Flynn. I just don't trust the twins.
It's all right, Nurse Flynn. If Mr. McMurphy doesn't want to take his medication orally, I'm sure we can arrange for him to take it some other way. But I don't think he'd like
it. I bet you'd like that, wouldn't you, Hardin, huh? Here, give it! Hey, Matt. If you think she's so bad, why didn't you tell her to fuck herself? God almighty, she got you guys coming or going, huh? What do you think she is, Martin? Some kind of champ?
No, I thought you were the champ.
All right. Well, how's about a bet?
Bet on what?
Well, I bet in 1 week. 1 week I can stick a bug so far her ass she don't know whether to shoot or wind her wristwatch. What do you say? You want to bet, huh? You want to bet?
I'll bet. I bet a dime.
All right. Martini bets a whole dime. We got any other takers?
Matt, you do something like that, you're gonna get trouble.
Jesus Christ, I've never seen a scarier looking boy in my life, am I right? You're as bad as the chief, Billy.
Oh, you'll be the same once you've been to the shock shop.
The shock shop?
Yeah, any violent or overly aggressive behavior towards patients or members of staff is a one-way ticket to 3,000 volts, my friend. Electroshock therapy, you know? It's nasty stuff.
Is that right, huh? But she can't do nothing unless she gets you going. Well, unless she makes you crack up in some way, like busting in the nose or cussing her out.
So you'll be okay as long as you keep down that temper.
Well, then the bet's still on!
All right, let's raise the stakes. $10 apiece for Billy and I.
Deal! Mr. McMurphy, may I ask what this little activity is?
Oh, no, ma'am. We're just playing a little game.
I'm sure this isn't some form of gambling.
Gambling? Oh, hell no. This is a sure thing.
I certainly hope not. Gambling is against board policy.
Well, actually, Nurse Ratchet, on the subject of board policy, I'm thinking about something Doc's fist. You know, about getting things off your chest. And, well, there's a couple of things I'd like to get off my chest, if you don't mind.
Well, that's very good, Randall. Go ahead.
All right. Well, today, as you may or may not know, doesn't matter, is the opening of the World Series. Now, what I suggest is that we change the work detail tonight so that we can all watch the ball game.
Well, what you're asking is that we change a very carefully worked out schedule.
Well, change never hurts. You know, a little variety.
That's not necessarily true, Mr. Murphy. A lot of men on this board take a long time to get used to the schedule. Change it now, and they might find it very disturbing. As I recall, Mr. Gamblin, you refused to eat for 3 days until we allowed you to turn the set on at 6 instead of 6:30.
Man deserves to know the news, don't he? Fucker's gonna bomb us here to hell. He'll be weak before you.
nerd ratchet.
Well, a change like this requires some thought. I will mention it in my staff meeting next week.
Next week? But the series will be half done by then.
There's Ratchet. Doesn't Dr. Spinney talk about this water for the democratic community? I think we should put it to a vote.
That's right. That's right. Democracy, Nurse Ratchet. Come on. One vote. There you are! I don't want to lose you, babies! What you doing over here, Chief? Holy Christ, about 10,000 pieces of gum, huh? I like your moves, Chief. You do better than that 100-year-old crap, am I right? Here,
I don't want to see her no more.
Nurse now, is there?
Well, I suppose. You can
get your ass back to bed. Go on now. Get out of here. Go on. Shit, I gotta deal with.
Finger marks and smooches. Scuffs all over the damn place. Damn. Big nurse, see this, she'll raise sand for sure. She'll beat me with that big brown bag of hers. You know what that woman's like. I mean, why not just, beat her back. Go on, man. First, pry her mouth open with this mop, and I'll twist it and push it down, and I'll rev it and rev it and rev it.
Early one morning while making the rounds, I took a shot of cocaine and I shot my window.
Hey there, old buddy. What's the chance of getting some toothpaste for my grinders?
We didn't open that cabinet till about 6:45.
Oh, that's where it is. Locked in the cabinet.
That's right.
Now, why do you reckon they keep the toothpaste locked up? I mean, it ain't like it's dangerous now, is it?
War policy, that's the reason. I mean, what do you suppose everyone has to brush their teeth whenever it's
in the... I think I see what you're driving at. You're saying that if it weren't war policy, people would be brushing their teeth whenever the spirit moved them, right?
That's right,
and Lordy, can you imagine? I mean, teeth being brushed at 6:30, 6:20, hell, maybe even 6:00.
Oh, come on, man, I got work to do!
Hey, wait a minute. So what do we have down here?
That will be soap.
Ah, well, I generally use paste, but, we'll look into that war policy shit later. Oh, how are you, Nurse Brack? Shit! How's it on the outside?
Miss McMurphy, if you've finished showing off your manly physique, I'd like to go and get dressed. You can't run around here in a towel.
Towel's against war policy, too, huh? All right.
Stop! Don't you dare.
Oh, surely I gotta follow ward policy, miss. You know, I don't want to get hooked up to your little battery charger! Ain't they some shit?
Mr. McMurphy, I'd like you to go and get dressed. Mr. Warren, on with your work.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, hey there, Martini.
Thank you. Oh, hell. The gruff sensation. Bet they give a man? Hey, why don't I show ya?
Mr. McMurphy!
Do you want a watch or something?
Hey, Kenny, come over. Well, I've been thinking. I want to throw a party for a couple of the guys in here.
Yeah, yeah, you
can
bring Sandy in.
Bring some liquor, too, and we'll fix it to be the greatest brawl that ever got flung in a loony bin.
Earth ain't got shit on me, all right? I'm running things in this here war, and I say we gotta celebrate that.
Far out.
Group meeting time. Group meeting, gentlemen. Miss McMurphy, I'm afraid your visitor will have to leave.
But I just got...
Leave it! Say so long to the fellas.
Catch you later, boys.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.
I love you!
Bye.
George says bye.
I call for a group meeting, gentlemen. Boys!
Yes, ma'am.
Billy, I would like to talk a little bit about your speech problem. Can you recall, Billy, when you first began to stutter?
The very first word I said, I stuttered. I said, mum. and when I first asked the gal out, I said, will you be my...
Your mother has spoken to me about this at some length, Billy. The girls, I mean. There was one. Cecilia. According to your mother, it was her that worsened your stutter. Apparently, she's quite a bit. Is that what frightened you, Billy?
No.
Then what was it?
I don't know.
Did you explain to her how you felt?
Flowers, and I said, Cecilia, will you marry me?
Your mother also told me that you never told her about the proposal. Billy, why didn't you tell her about it?
Because
on account of my mother.
Your mother.
Every time she comes here, it makes me feel awful.
Your mother loves you, baby.
I know. Disappointment to her. And I say to her, Mama, I ain't right in the head. I can't even talk straight. And yet she still goes on. And pretty soon I wanna kill myself. So I try.
Billy, have you ever thought that perhaps you were trying to punish her? Anybody else has something they'd like to talk about? Mr. Cheswick.
Yeah, well, yesterday, Mac was talking about a World Series, a baseball game, and I've never seen a baseball game before, and I think that'd be good therapy, wouldn't it, Nurse Ratched?
I thought you decided this issue.
Well, no, because that was yesterday. I think there's a new game today. Isn't there, Mac?
That's right, Chez, and we want a new vote on it, don't we?
Gentlemen, do any of you feel that Mr. McMurphy is imposing his personal desires on you? What if we moved him to another ward?
Oh, he can't send him to the store because we're going to have a fucking vote.
Yeah, I would like another vote, please, ma'am.
One more vote will satisfy you. Very well. Again, all those in favor of changing the work schedule to watch the baseball game.
All right, guys, let's get them up. Which one of you fucking nuts has got any guts? Martini? Billy, get them up! Come on! Crappy things I've ever heard!
This meeting
Kesey. You want to watch the baseball World Series, the ball game? You want to watch the World Series? Just raise your hands up, Chief. Just raise them up. Show her you can do it. Just show her you can still do it. Oh, my God, you got them up. Come on, Chief. Come on, Chief. Raise your hands up, Chief. Leave it, will you, Billy?
Matt.
Kicks. He delivers. It's up in the middle. It's a base hit. Richardson's rounded first. He's going for second. The ball's in the deep right center. Then it's a chest. He's over in the corner. Got the ball off. Here comes the throw. Richardson's around the derby slide. He's in there. He's safe. It's an elbow martini. He's up in the second base. All right, Kovacs. Oh, Kovacs is in bad trouble. Bad fucking trouble, baby. All right. Here's Trash. He's the next batter. Trash comes in. Kovacs gets the side for Grosbro. He puts. It's a strike! Kovacs turns the ball. Takes a snap it up like a fucking firecracker. All right, there's Trash.
Billy, sit
Trash
down.
Swings. And it's a long
line. Will you sit down, please?
In left center. It's going!
Will you sit down? I'm
fucking waiting before I die. All right, fellas. Listen up.
Because it's the great Mickey Mantle now. All right, here comes the pitch. That's a swing! It's a fucking over! Come on, boys, I need a rant!
Stop it!
Papa, I ain't big enough. I ain't big enough.
You're already here. But what we can do is take away certain privileges. Considering the circumstances, we've decided to take away certain privileges which no doubt encourage this rebellion to happen. For 30 days, there'll be no viewing of television. Cigarettes will be provided by myself and Nurse Flynn and rationed to a pack a day. Also, playing cards in recreation hours is hereby rescinded.
Is that all?
Not quite. I would also like to return to the subject of patient Mr. McCarthy.
Shocking.
This gentleman is a record of Mr. McMurphy's winning whilst being croupier of this little Monte Carlo deal on the board. How much did you lose, Mr. Scanlon? Billy? I'm sure you're all aware of what your personal losses are, but do you know what Mr. McMurphy's winnings come to? According to deposits, he has made over $300. I just didn't want there to be any delusions to what his motives were.
He never made any pretense about his motives.
Satan's gonna take us for all he got. By God, Ethan!
No cards? How are we gonna win our money back?
My. After all, we have weeks, months, years.
What do you mean by that?
By what, Randall?
Well, that years bit. You know, my sentence has only got 5 months to run.
Mr. McMurphy, this is not like a jail sentence. In jail, you're given a date ahead when you know you'll be set free. But here, if you're committed,
you're telling me that you and the fucking doctors can keep me here until what? You're good and ready to turn me loose?
That's correct.
Jesus Christ, are you kidding? And you. You guys let me go on hassling Nurse Ratchet here, knowing how much I had to lose and what. You never told me nothing.
Jack, wait a minute. I didn't know anything about this. None of us.
Oh, bullshit, Harding. What is this? Some kind of con? Are you guys out to get me? Is that what it is? Huh?
I'm voluntary now. I'm not committed. I don't have to stay here. I can go home anytime I want.
You can go home anytime you want. You're bullshitting me, right? He's bullshitting me, right?
No, Randall. He's telling the truth. As a matter of fact, we have very few men here who are committed. There's Mr. Scanlon. Mr. Bromden. The other chronics. And you.
Martini, you're voluntary. Billy, for Christ's sake, you gotta be committed, right? You're just a young kid. What are you doing in here? You should be out in the convertible, bird-dogging chicks and bagging people. What's the matter with you? Hey, what's so funny about that? I mean, all you guys do is complain about how you can't fucking stand it in this place, and then what? You haven't got the guts to just walk out? I mean, come on, seriously, if none of you got the guts to just up and leave.
That's it, man.
We haven't got guts, man. You think I don't want a convertible? Or a good girlfriend? But have you ever had anyone laugh at you? No. Cause you're so tough. Well, I ain't so tough, man. Nor is Chesley. Nor is Hardy.
What do you think? You're crazy or something? Well, you're not! Hey! You're not. You're no crazier than the average looking assholes walking around on the streets!
Those are some very challenging observations, Randall. I'm sure some of the men would like to comment.
I want to know! What's the order of ups and takes I'm talking here?
Well, in answer to your question, Mrs. Sam.
Yeah, Mrs. Ratchet. And I want to know why I can't have my cigarettes. Can I have my cigarettes, please,
Mr. Chester? Mr. Chester, you will sit down and wait your turn. Go ahead. Sit down. Mr. Scout, you know that if we left the door open, you'd just go right back to bed after breakfast. Am I right?
So fucking what?
Ratchet, can I please have my
cigarette? Get the cigarettes, will you? Chesley can just sit down.
I want my cigarette.
Mr. Scanlon, we've discussed many times that time spent in the company of others is very therapeutic. Whilst time spent brooding alone only increases the feeling of separation. You remember that, don't you?
So, you mean to say it's sick to want to be by yourself?
Miss Ratchet!
Mr. Chesley, you will sit down this instant!
I will not sit down inside my cigarette!
And someone give him a cigarette!
Want some gum?
Thank you. juicy fruit.
Can you hear me too?
Oh, you bet.
What they all think, you're deaf and dumb. Jesus Christ! Dave, you fooled him! Hey, you fooled them all! God damn it!
What's two guys like us doing in a fucking place like this? We gotta get out of here. You know what I mean? Get out.
Oh no, McMurphy. I'd be afraid.
Afraid? How's that?
I ain't big enough.
Ain't big enough? Jesus Christ, you really are crazy. You're the biggest goddamn Indian I've ever seen.
I don't mean big like that.
I know, Chief. I know, Chief.
My papa was bigger. He was a full chief, and his name was Tina Milituna. That means the pine that stands tallest on the mountain. But they started working on him. They wanted our waterfall, our land. Papa fought it for a long time. He fought it even when they cut off his hair. Even when they beat on him in town. The government said, here's a big old pot of gold. And you know what he said? He said, what can you pay for the way a man lives? What can you pay? They didn't understand. Then Papa started drinking, and he didn't stop till he was dead. The black machine, they started working on him, Murphy, the way they're working on you.
Why, hell, Chief, looks to me like you've grown half a foot already.
You hear the birds, McMurphy? That's all I hear. Canadian geese flying north.
Yeah, right here, Chief.
Wah, brah, limberlock.
Huh?
An old nursery rhyme of Papa taught me. Free geese fly.
You're next, McMurphy.
Tanner, Chief. Tanner, that's where we'll go, Chief. Tanner,
you go off!
Tanner, Tanner, Chief!
Mr. McMurphy, how are you today?
Just dandy, Doc.
Glad to hear it. Oh, I'm not entirely surprised to see you here. Leaving aside yesterday's, altercations, how do you feel you're getting on?
That fucking nurse, man. You know, she ain't honest.
Nurse Ratchet is one of the finest nurses in this institution.
Well, I don't want to break up your gang or nothing, but she's something of a cunt, ain't she, Doc?
How do you mean?
She likes her rigged game, you know what I mean?
You know, Randall, we've been observing you for some time now, and I must say, I do not see any signs whatsoever of any mental illness. I think you've been trying to have us on.
What do you want me to do, Doc, huh? Hey, what do you want me to do? You want me to take a shit on the floor? Is that crazy enough for you?
Have you ever heard the saying, a rolling stone gathers no moss? Does that mean anything to you, Randall?
Yeah, it's the same as that. What's that?
Conductance.
A little dab will do you, Doc. Yeah, same as,
Don't wash your dirty underwear in public.
Not quite sure I understand what you mean.
Well, I'm smarter than him, ain't I?
No. Please bite down on this, Mr. McMurphy. Mr. Warren.
I'm ready, Doc. March to the door.
Ready, sir.
Fuck! And who for the bride?
that's me, Candy Star.
Okay. Do you see how you take billing to having to hold for as long as rules and regulations may apply?
I do!
And use billing take Sammy to love and to cherish until Mr. Turco comes and kicks us all to bed.
Hell yeah, he does!
Most personal bat, he asks you accept these two into your kingdom with your well-known compassion, but keep the door ajar for the rest of us. For this may be our final plate until we are doomed henceforth to the terrible burden of sanity. Most likely in the morning we'll be lined up against a wall and fired upon with bullets of Paxil, Thorazine, and Prozac. Go, children, sin while ye may, for tomorrow you'll be drugged into apathetic slumber.
Billy the Claw! Good luck to you, son! You're gonna need it!
Ken, come with me. Mr. Harding, I don't think you're peculiar at all.
That's okay, Jess. As long as you're enjoying the party, my boy.
Oh, yes, very much, sir. I enjoy it very much.
This one's for George.
Remove this woman and check the dormitories, please.
Gladly. Come on, girl, fun's over.
Mr. Martini! Mr. Martini, my hat! My hat! My hat, Miss Martini!
I can't explain everything.
No, no, I'm not.
That's right. That's right!
What worries me, Billy, is how your mother is going to take this.
You don't have to tell her, Nurse Ratchet.
I don't have to tell her. But your mother and I are old friends. You know that, Billy.
Please, don't tell my mother.
Shouldn't you have thought about that when you took that woman into that room?
No. I didn't. No. They did. They all did.
Everybody? Who did? You tell me who did, Billy.
Murphy.
Billy.
Please. Don't tell my mother.
Mr. Warren, would you take Billy and take him to Dr. Spivey's office and have him wait for me there?
Please, don't.
Sorry, Billy. Sorry.
No. Please, don't. No!
So we've had a party. Thrown, no doubt, by Mr. McMurphy. You've already plundered these poor, sick people of everything they have. And now you're packed and ready to rub up against good to save your own skin. Mr. McMurphy, there's no more profit to be made from these helpless. Gentlemen, here's what we're going to do. You're going to get washed and dressed into some clean clothing. You're going to help tidy up this mess and fix anything that's been broken. Tomorrow, when you wake, you will continue with your days as normal until we find an appropriate punishment.
No!
Billy, no!
Billy, no! Billy, no! Billy, no!
Billy,
no!
Billy,
no!
Upstairs, and he's meek as a lion.
Who says?
Check them.
Check them, you foot of shit!
Mr. Warren.
They said you escaped. I knew you wouldn't leave without me. Now we can do it, Mac. I feel as big as a goddamn...
See that, Papa? I done it. You see that?
I'm a long way from home.
adaptation, gentlemen. Mr. Ruckley, Mr. Ellis.
Absolutely. I'm a long way from home, and so all alone, homesick like I never thought I'd be. I'm a long way from home, and everything is wrong. Someone please watch over me. I'm not accustomed to these feelings. Loneliness is burning in my soul. Sometimes the mind is so misleading. I wish I'd stayed at home like I was told. I'm a long way from home, and so all alone, homesick like I never thought I'd be. I'm a long way from home, and everything is wrong. Someone please watch over me.